Hello, my name is Dr. Ibrahimian, and in this channel, I go over problem-solving strategies, mainly in math competitions. In this video, I'm going to go over problem form from the International Math Competition for University Students that was held a few days ago. This is IMC 2025, problem 4. Let A be an even positive integer. Find all real numbers x such that we have this equality that holds for every positive integer b. And this floor function is what they are using here. Okay, so the first thing is when I look at a nth root of a number, I would be able to approximate that if I use the binomial formula. But for the binomial formula, for the usual binomial formula, you need an exponent that is integer, but this is actually going to hold for every exponent alpha, that this is going to be the same as alpha choose n equals 0 to infinity times x to the power of n. This is the power series for 1 plus x to the power of alpha, and this holds for every x between negative 1 and 1, and for every alpha that is a real number. What is this alpha choose n? Alpha choose n is alpha minus 1. By definition, this is the product of n consecutive numbers starting from alpha. In other words, you take alpha, subtract 1 consecutively, n minus 1 times, so you get n numbers on top divided by n factorial. So now I can start looking at this expression and trying to approximate this a root of b to the a plus x. But because of the fact that I have in the binomial formula, I have a 1, I gotta have to factor b to the a. So let's look at the left side. The left side is a b to the a plus x times b to the a minus 1. So I'm gonna factor b to the a. A root of b to the a becomes b, and then the inside we have 1 plus x over b to the a, and then I have b to the a minus 1, so this becomes b to the a. So I'm trying to approximate this one. So this is approximately b to the a times 1 plus x over b to the a to the power of a, 1 over a. In fact, this is exactly the same as that. And then I can evaluate this one right now, the power series, and I can approximate that by looking at the Taylor polynomials. So the first term is 1, the next term is 1 over a choose 1, x over b to the a, the next one is 1 over a choose 2, x over b to the a squared, etc. And I can truncate that, look at, let's say, the first two terms, and this will give me an approximation. So this is approximately b to the a times 1 over a choose a 1 is 1 over a times x over b to the a, and this is the same as b to the a x over a. Now if you look at the right side of this equality is exactly this, except that I have a floor function. So it's b to the a plus floor of x over a. So this is approximately the same as b to the a plus floor of x to the a. So the equality seems to hold for lots of values of x, at least with this approximation. It depends on how good this approximation is. Now, before I can get to complete the rest of the solution and go ahead and make this more rigorous, let's look at the expression that we have. The expression that we have is eighth root of b to the a plus x. So this expression b to the a plus x must be greater than or equal to 0 because a is even. And when is that greater than or equal to 0? Well, the smallest value is 1 plus x, so this would have to be greater than or equal to 0, and this is true for every positive integer b. So that means x must be at least negative 1. So this is the first assumption that it is being imposed. Now let's look at this approximation and see if we can make this more rigorous and see how we can proceed. So if you look at the next term, typically for Taylor polynomials, the next term is going to be the error term. So what's the next term? The next term is 1 over a choose 2 times x squared over b to the power of 2a, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, so that's the next step. This is equal to 1 over a minus 1 divided by 2 x squared over b to the 2a. And I know that this is negative because 1 over a is less than 1. A is an even positive integer. So I suspect that If I approximate the expression by this, this would be an overestimate. So I would suspect that this whole thing is smaller than b to the a plus x over a because of the fact that the next term is negative. So let's see if that is in fact true. Is it true that b to the a th root of 1 plus x over b to the a, is it true that this is less than b to the a plus x over a, maybe less than or equal to? Let's first divide by b to the a and see what we get. So we get a th root of 1 plus x over b to the a is less than or equal to 1 plus x over a times b to the a. We can raise both sides to the power of a. This is the same as saying 1 plus x over b to the a is less than or equal to 1 plus x over a times b to the a raised to the power of a. And this is a pretty familiar inequality. This is called Bernoulli inequality. And this can be shown by the induction that 1 plus x to the power of n is always greater than or equal to 1 plus nx. This is true for every positive integer n and for every x starting from negative 1 to infinity. And this can be done by induction on n. So how does that apply? If you look at 1 plus x over a times b to the power of a raised to the power of a, this is greater than or equal to 1 plus a times x over a b to the power of a, which is 1 plus x over b to the power of a. Okay, so this tells us that in fact the left side, so let's kind of summarize what we have, b to the a times a th root of 1 plus x over b to the a is in fact less than or equal to b to the a plus x over a. So when does the equality hold? So the given equality, which was the floor of this side is the same as the floor of that side, because remember that b and a are both integer, so floor applied to the right side, b to the a comes out of the floor. So the given equality holds if and only if I can say the left side b to the a 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to, in fact floor of that, is greater than or equal to floor of the right side, which is b to the a plus x over a. So this is exactly when the equality holds. So when does this inequality hold? This is the same as saying the inside is greater than or equal to that floor function. So this is the same as saying b to the a th root of 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to b to the a plus floor of x over a. So this is the same as the equality that they gave us. Okay, so that's the first thing that we need to check. Okay, and also remember that x was at least negative 1. So far we have obtained these two things. Now, for simplicity, let me call this floor of x over a n, because we know that's an integer and we're going to work with that integer, and that gives us the range for x. So let's call this floor of x over a to be n, and we know that this n is at least negative 1. It can't be anything less than negative 1 because x is greater than or equal to negative 1. Now, let's just start rewriting this inequality. So the inequality is b to the a plus times a root of 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to b to the a plus n. Let's divide by b to the a. So we get a root of 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to 1 plus n over b to the a. So this is exactly the same as saying that the equality holds. And this is equivalent to saying 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to 1 plus n over b to the a to the power of a. Now, let's look at the right side and expand the right side, because that can be expanded using binomial formula. So what does that give us? That gives us 1 plus a n over b to the a plus a choose 2 n squared over b to the 2a plus a choose 3 n cubed over b to the 3a plus dot dot dot. So this is the right hand side of this equality. Now, we can get rid of this term. 1 gets cancelled. And we also know that an, so let's write down what n was. N was floor of x over a. This tells us that n is less than or equal to x over a and less than n plus 1. So this means na is in fact less than or equal to x less than n plus 1 times a. So it seems like in most cases the left side should be less than the right side, because this term is approximately x over b to the a, and the left side is already x over b to the a. So we're going to have to take some cases and do some case work. For example, if n is equal to 0, the inequality is always going to hold. So if n equals 0, then the inequality always holds, because the left side is x over b to the a, which is greater than or equal to 0, because floor function is 0, and the right side is exactly 0. Okay, so that's one thing that we get, that the equality holds for n equals 0. Now, what are the other possibilities? We can take n to be positive. If n is positive, then the right side seems to be much larger than the left side. So let's suppose that n is positive. So if n is positive, then we get this. Then we get x over b to the a is greater than or equal to a over b to the a times n plus a choose 2 a squared, or rather n squared over b to the 2a plus etc. And this would have to be true for every positive integer b. Well, if you look at b equals 1, set b equals 1 and see what we get. So we get x must be greater than or equal to a n plus a times a minus 1 over 2 n squared plus etc. So now, at the very least, we know that this is at most n plus 1 times a by the discussion that we had over here. So we can replace that by n plus 1 times a. That's greater than, in fact, a n plus a times a minus 1 over 2 n squared plus, and there's more terms here potentially. N a cancels, so we get a is greater than a times a minus 1 over 2 n squared plus, etc. Okay, so we can divide by a, and this inequality seems to fail if a is at least 2. So if a is at least 4. So if a is at least 4, then we would have 1 is greater than or equal to a minus 1 over 2 n squared plus a choose 3. The next term is a minus 1, a minus 2 over 6 n cubed plus, etc. So the next term is going to be a minus 1 times a minus 2 over 6 n cubed. And this is going to fail. This side is going to be more than n minus 1 over 2, which is 3 over 2. And then n is at least 1, and everything else is positive. So this is not going to happen. So that means if a is at least 4, then n cannot be positive. So n is less than or equal to 0. So this is if a is at least 4. Okay, so let's see what happens if n is negative 1, because we know that n is at least negative 1. So suppose n is negative 1, so that means 0 is greater than x over a, greater than or equal to negative 1. And let's see what we get. So this tells us that x is less than 0, greater than or equal to negative a. But remember that x was greater than or equal to negative 1. So this means x is between negative 1 and 0. Okay, so if that's the case, the inequality that we need is this. Let's go back and see what we had. We have to plug in negative 1 into the inequality. So the inequality is 1 plus x over b to the a. A th root of that is greater than or equal to 1 minus 1 over b to the a. This is the inequality that we need to prove. Okay, which is the same as saying 1 plus x over b to the a is greater than or equal to 1 minus 1 over b to the a to the a. And this inequality is valid. This is valid because x is at least negative 1 and a is at least 2. In fact, 1 would work too. So this is going to work. So to summarize, if a is at least 4, then x would have to be between negative 1 all the way to a, because we showed that n can be 0 and can be negative 1. If a is equal to 2, then x inside negative 1 to a works, but it's possible that other values of x would work as well. So let's now suppose that a is 2, and let's get to do this one separately, because this one has to be done separately. So let's take a look at what happens if a is 2. So what happens if a is 2? We have the square root of 1 plus x over b squared is greater than or equal to 1 plus n over b squared. We're going to rewrite this. This is 1 plus x over b to b squared is greater than or equal to 1 plus n over b squared squared. And in this case, I know that x is at least 2, because I'm starting to look at n equals 1 and above. So what does that give me? So this gives me 1 plus x over b squared is greater than or equal to 1 plus 2n over b squared plus n squared over b to the fourth. So that's what I have. Cancel 1, multiply by b squared, so it gives me 2n plus n squared over b squared. But I know that x is, I know that x over 2 is between n and n plus 1. So this means the left side is less than 2n plus 2, 2 times n plus 1. So that's greater than 2n plus n squared. And I can replace b by 1. So this tells me that 2 is greater than n squared. So now I know that n is at least 1, because we looked at n 0 and negative 1 separately. So this means n must be exactly equal to 1. So in this case, n must be equal to 1. Now let's look at n equals 1 and see what we get. We get x over b squared is greater than or equal to 2 over b squared plus 4 over b to the fourth. And we also know that x is between 2 and it is less than 4. So we know that this would have to be true for every b. Now let's multiply by b squared. This is greater than or equal to 2 plus 4 over b squared for every b that is a positive integer. And by the way, this is 1, not 4. So this would have to be true for every positive integer b, which means x would have to be greater than or equal to 3, because the smallest value of the left side, the right side, is in fact 3. So bottom line is, if a equals 2, then x is inside negative 1 to 2, or 3 to 4. And we checked what happens if x, a is greater than or equal to 4. This gives you anything from negative 1 all the way to a. And that brings me to the end of this video. So I will see you in the next video.